Hello and welcome to Hadoop Exam Learning Resources. In this session, we will be discussing about AWS Solution Architect Professional Level question and answers. Now we will be discussing question number 18. So now let me go to question first before discussing the explanation. So what question number 18 is saying, this is your image. You can click on this and it would launch here. Basically, you can see this is an image that would be launched here. So what question is saying, refer the image where the EC2 classic instance is outside of VPC. So this is a EC2 instance which is outside of VPC. Okay. Now you wish to communicate with RDS which is inside VPC. This RDS instance which you created which is inside VPC, which is the best solution for this solution basically, correct, this problem. So we want to have both directional communication from instance which is outside VPC. Outside VPC in EC2 instances is only possible when your instances is launched long back and you are still using those instances, correct? If now you start with the new reason or something, so then it would not be allow you to create EC2 instances without VPC. So that is what here. But let's see, so question is asking for that, so we need to understand. So now before answering this question, let's go and learn some concept basically here on question number 18. So let me go over here. So a DB instance in a VPC accessed by EC2 instance not in a VPC. What you would do basically, classic link. What is classic link? You can communicate between an EC2 instance that is not in Amazon Virtual Private Cloud or VPC and Amazon RDS DB instance that is in a VPC by using a classic link. So you need to use a classic link solution provided by Amazon. Using this AWS feature, you can connect an EC2 instance to a logically isolated database where you define the IP address range and control the access control list to manage the network traffic. So this is one new feature which is completely different. This is to support people or infrastructure where instances are outside of the EC2, and classics link is the name. You don't have to use public IP address or tunneling to communicate with the DB instance in the VPC. So you don't have to create a public IP addresses. You don't have to create a VPN network or anything, correct, for this. Classic link helps for this. You're doing this, solving this problem. This arrangement provides you with higher throughput and lower latency connectivity for inter-instance communication. Because your RDS instance is also in one kind of EC2 instance only on which your Oracle is installed, correct? So you need to have a good communication. If you do VPN, then you need to worry about throughput and everything. But classic link does not create this kind of issue. So you should go for the classic link. The DB instances must be in private subnet that is not open to public. It cannot be set publicly accessible if you want to use classic link. Prices, when you use classic link, an application on EC2 instance can connect to DB instance by using endpoint of the DB instance, and classic link is available at no charge. So there is no cost associated with classic link. It's absolutely free from Amazon to use this. But this kind of infrastructure ideally you should not create. If you are creating or setting up a new environment, then avoid this thing. Like, you should always have everything in the VPC and corresponding subnet availability zone. So you should use those features. Okay, so to answer this question, basically very straightforward question, like we would be using classic link here. Other all are not a valid option. VPN we discussed, not remote desktop, it's illogical option itself. Then AWS VPN Cloud Hub, again it's a VPN related solution using Cloud Hub model, but which we don't want to use. So classic link is the only answer. So let me submit this, and you can see here this is an explanation as well for this question. So that's all about question number 18. Thanks for watching, and I hope this is helping you to grow your career, and wish you all the best. And please visit hadoopexam.com for understand more and more. And if you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe it. I'm stopping now.